Sienna for the Reverend. Nice was it? Nice was going on over here, not in a move.
Hey, Baba,
I'm not
going to be.
No,
I don't know. I don't know. I'll give you a business.
Yeah, yeah.
Are
you going to go back to school? Back
I'm going to go to the hospital.
bia we mo boti kwa na ya boti. Boti kwa na. Si mi ni se se. Mo ma sta di Jesus joy. Was supposed to have sang the Jesus joy with her. Jesus joy is not with her.
Beloved in Christ, we are all welcome to Christ the King Parish. We are here to witness the marriage ceremony between Manuel Harry Sawyer and Natasha Rosalind Sedinam Tete. Mass is about to begin. Shall we all please stand? As we sing from Catholic hymn number 10, hymn 10, All People That on Earth Do Dwell. For our intro, it will sing from Catholic hymn number 393, hymn 393, in the brochure, page 9. Praise to the Lord, the Almighty.
Thank you.
Natasha, may the Lord send you help from the holy place and give you support from Zion. May He grant you your heart's desire and fulfill every one of your designs. Hallelujah. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the kingdom of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Brothers and sisters, I welcome all of you this afternoon to the sacrament of holy matrimony between Manuel Harris Sawyer and Natasha Rosalind Sedinam Tete. I want to pray for God's blessings upon their union and to ask God, who is love, to be the love of their marriage. We join our hearts, our welfare sinfulness. We join the angels and saints in praising God. The human race, will that man and wife should be one. Join, we pray, in an unbreakable bond of love, these your servants, Manuel and Natasha, who are to be united in the covenant of marriage, so that as you make their love fruitful, they may become, by your grace, witnesses to charity itself. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
We'll take our first reading. Our first reading is from the book of Ephesians, chapter 5, verse 2. Continued from 21 to 33. First reading.
Ephesians 5, verses 2 to 22-33. Brethren, walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself up for us. Husbands, love your wives as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her, that he might sanctify her, having cleansed her by washing of water with the word, that he might present the church to himself in splendor, without spot or wrinkle or any such thing, that she might be holy and without blemish. Even so, husbands should love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. For no man ever hates his own flesh, but nourishes and cherishes it, as Christ does the church, because we are members of his body. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. This is a great mystery, and I mean in reference to Christ and the church. However, let each one of you love his wife as himself, and let the wife see that that she respects her husband. The word of the Lord.
To God.
Father,
For our responsorial psalm, we shall sing from Catholic hymn number 32. Hymn 32. Beloved in Christ, shall we all please stand for the gospel acclamation?
Thank you. Hallelujah. If we love one another, God abides in us, and his love is perfected in us. Hallelujah. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. I love you just as the Father loves me. Remain in my love. If you obey my commands, you will remain in my love, just as I obeyed my Father's command and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. My commandment is this: love one another just as I have loved you. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Manuel and Natasha made a special request for this song. And Father, we want you, before you speak, to allow the choir to sing the song. And I told Manuel it won't happen. But I see why you like the song. Because as you are taking this bold step in your life, you are asking God to speak to your heart, to speak to your mind. And that is what this sacrament is all about. That every day of your married life, you have to ask God to speak to your heart. Remember that we've had several conversations about what love is, what the sacrament is all about. So today I don't have many things to say. I have preached to you already. What I want to tell you is this. Think of when you first fell in love and treasure that moment as you live your married life. That is my message for you. Because it's always good to go back to the beginnings. You remember that when Jesus resurrected from the dead, he told the disciples, he told Mary Magdalene, tell my disciples to meet me in Galilee. Galilee was where their mission began, where he called them to be apostles. And through it all, there had been disappointment and everything. But he tells them they should meet me where it all began. And that is why I'm saying that always recall the beginnings. All the things, Manuel, you did for Natasha to say that yes. And Natasha, all the things you also did for Manuel to be convinced that you are the one he wants to spend the rest of his life with. Those are things you must treasure and keep going back to. Not to say that you should be satisfied with those aspects, no. But for you to know that if you work harder at your love, what we are doing today will last forever. Because happy marriages don't just happen. It's like having a very beautiful flower. You can't ignore the flower and still expect that it should blossom the way you want. You must tend it, nurture it, so that the flower will blossom and would give you what your heart desires. So after today, don't sleep on your love. In the first reading, we are reminded of that story in Genesis. For this reason, a man will leave his mother and father and cling to his wife, and they shall no longer be two, but one flesh. So there must always be leaving in order to cling. And in that unity lies that oneness. But you will still remain two individual people, two individuals. So how can you live your distinctive lives and still be united as one? But that is what love does. Love always unites and builds. So Paul is telling us so much about love. Wives, submit to your husbands. I am told feminists don't like that line in the Bible. When they hear wives submit to your husbands, they say that the Bible is very patriarchal. But go to the next line, and the scripture says, husbands, love your wives. And that greatest act of love is the sacrificial love of Christ on the cross. It's a love which gives its all without counting the cost. So, Manuel, Paul says that love Natasha without counting the cost. And Natasha, the word of God says submit to Manuel. It doesn't mean that you won't have opinions. And doesn't mean I take her opinions for granted. It only means that as you are loving her and she is submitting to you, together those two sides of love become manifest. Because in Jesus, we see a love that submits to the Father. So Philippians 2 will tell us, though he was in the form of God, Jesus took equality with God. He humbled himself and became obedient unto death. So that love which submits is also part of the love of Christ. So Paul is only pointing out the two sides of the same coin. You are entering this marriage, and you are doing this of your own free will. Remember that when we say love, it means the choice to will the good of the other person. That is how St. Thomas Aquinas explains love. So it is not, we don't have the romanticism kind of trappings that you will understand with love. But he's pointing at what the essential features of love is all about. The choice. Once it is a choice, it's not just based on feeling. It's a rational decision to will the good of your partner. So you recall, when we're discussing marriage, I told you that for the church, for the Catholic Church, the first good of marriage is the good of the spouses. So you are not entering this marriage asking yourself, Manuel, what is in for me? And neither are you also asking, what is in this for me? Your overriding concern should be, how am I going to pursue the good of Manuel? So you wake up thinking of his good. And everything about goodness must be your priority. And same for you, Manuel. You are entering into this because you have the good of Natasha at heart. So love is always a choice, a rational decision to will the good of the other. And in that rational decision is the admission that the other person is not perfect. Because in God's scheme of creation, those who are perfect don't marry. Angels don't marry. Human beings are the ones who marry. But human beings are always imperfect. But how are you going to create a perfection out of imperfection? That will require you, my dear friends, to always understand that as long as we live together, we will keep learning. We will keep learning the likes and dislikes of one another. You know, when love is sweet, it shouldn't be because everything is rosy. Should be because you fought your battles, and in those battles, love still stood strong. Should I say it again? when love is sweet, should it be because everything is rosy? Should it be because you have fought your battles and love still stands strong? And that is how come love is sweet. And if you want this love, which is this rational choice to seek each other's goodness, to keep growing stronger and stronger, then please, just apply some corporate principles to love. We all know this popular thing in corporate world that they call a SWOT analysis. Am I right? So in every organization, you're looking for what the strengths are, what the weaknesses are, what the opportunities are, what the threats are. It applies so much to marriage. Because both of you have your strengths. You all have your weaknesses. In this marriage, there will always be opportunities to make things better. But trust me, there will always also be threats to love. So how are you going to maximize your strengths? Work on your weaknesses. Look on the opportunities that will grow this love and deal with the threats so that you can have a healthy home. It will require that you must know and admit your mistakes when you are wrong. Remember, I have said that you are not perfect. And sometimes the threats come from our inability to just say, I am sorry. Natasha, I am told men don't like say, I am sorry. They prefer to show it through their actions that they are sorry. If you ask the woman, they will tell you. But Manuel, love is love. If you have to tell your wife, I am sorry, please do. It doesn't take anything away from you, who you are. It rather shows that you are a very well-seasoned and a matured man. And when your husband says, I am sorry, never make it difficult for a man to apologize. Because before they make the attempt to apologize, the things they have got, that have gone through their mind, only God knows. So if you try number one and you are difficult, oh, you may never hear it again. But please look at how you can always minimize your weaknesses. But always work on your strengths. And never allow your weakness to be greater than your strengths in this marriage. Sometimes, for this marriage to be beautiful, you don't always have to stick to your positions. It may just mean rethinking about what you think is right and what you think is wrong. How we can live this love together. There's a story I can't resist telling you about this couple who moved into a new neighborhood. And in this neighborhood, they only shared a wall, right? But their window was big glass, so you could see the next house. And each morning, they would meet in their dining to drink coffee. And the wife would tell the husband, hello, Manuel, just look through the window. Our next door neighbor, I don't think she knows how to wash. Why? Because the things she's drying are still very dirty. Then Manuel will smile and walk away. The next morning, Natasha will tell Manuel again, Manuel, oh, I think there is something wrong with your soap. Let us give them a gift, one of the soaps that we have that washes very well. Manuel smiles and walks away. The following week, Natasha says the same thing. Manuel, no, his rather must be the washing machine. You know we have two, give them one. Then Manuel smiled and walked away. Then Sunday before Mass, Natasha goes for coffee and looks across again and see everything clean on the drying line. So Manuel, come. They got it right after all. Either they have changed the washing machine or they have changed the soap Oh, I'm so happy for them. And my daughter says, Natasha, I cleaned the windows. I cleaned the windows. In other words, there was nothing wrong with them. Everything had to do with her window. In this love, from time to time, you must clean the window of love. Clean the window of love so that you can see clearly. Because there might not be anything wrong with what your partner is doing. Is there a perception with which you are looking at it? That may make all the difference. That if you cleaned your own window, you will end up appreciating each other better. Our prayers are with you. Master, speak, thy servant heareth. God has spoken. And you are going to sing again, a charge to keep I have, a God to glorify before your vows. So know that these vows that you are taking today is a charge that you are going to keep. And you are going to live this marriage to glorify God. And as you do this, I share with you this prayer. I have this book of wedding blessings. It's composed by Carol Merola. And that's my prayer for you. My prayer for you is this. That you will always remember the qualities that attracted you to each other when you first met. And how you felt as your feelings of attraction turned into respect, admiration, and finally love. That you work hard to turn your feelings of love into acts of love so that nothing and no one can divide you. That you will always have kind and loving hearts that are quick to ask for forgiveness when you are wrong, as well as to forgive when your partner is wrong. That your love might grow to bear all things, believe all things, and hope for all things, endure all things. I pray you place your marriage in God's hands, and that your love increases and overflows beyond anything you can yet imagine. May God, who is going to unite the two of you, accompanying you throughout your married life. Amen. And we now have the song, A Charge to Keep I Have.
My dear friends, you have come together in this church so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of the church's minister and this community. Christ blesses this love abundantly. He has already consecrated you in baptism, and now he enriches and strengthens you by a special sacrament so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. And so in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions. Manuel and Natasha, have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourself to each other in marriage?
Yes, I have.
Yes, I have.
Will you love and honor each other as man and wife for the rest of your lives?
Yes, I will. Yes, I will.
Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and His church?
Yes, I will.
Yes, I will.
Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, now turn and face each other. Join your right hands and declare your consent before God and His church.
I, Manuel Harry Sawyer, take you, Natasha Roslyn Titi, to be my wife. I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. I will love you and honor you all the days of my life.
I, Natasha Roslyn Sedinam Titi, take you, Manuel Harry Sawyer, to be my husband. I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. I will love you and honor you all the days of my life.
You have declared your consent before God and His church. The Lord in His goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with His blessings. What God has joined, no human being must divide. Amen. Lord, bless and consecrate these rings that we this day present to you, and that even as Natasha and Manuel exchange these rings, may these rings be a symbol of true faith in each other and always remind them of your love through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Natasha Roslyn Sedinam Titi, take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Manuel Harry Sawyer, take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Let us appreciate them. Manuel will now unveil his wife. Then they will congratulate each other and come and light the Paschal, the unity candle.
For the lighting of candle, we shall sing from Catholic hymn number 321, O Perfect Love, in the brochure, page 14.
Shall we please arise and pray? We pray for Manuel and Natasha, and after each prayer, let our response be. Those chosen to lead us in prayer should please come forward.
Catholic Church and its leaders, that God in his infinite wisdom will bless his church and endow its leaders with the grace to lead his flock on the path of righteousness as committed Christians and followers of the gospel. For this, let us pray to the Lord.
For Manuel and Natasha, that their love for each other may be modeled on Christ's love for his bride, the church, and that they will share in God's providence and enjoy the gift of children. For this, let us pray to the Lord.
For the parents and family of Manuel and Natasha, that they will continue to support them on the journey which begins at this altar, and that they will encourage them at every stage of their lives, no matter the circumstances. For this, let us pray to the Lord.
For those preparing for marriage, that they may understand fully the dignity and responsibilities of the marriage covenant and family life, and that married people everywhere will live in love and faithfulness all the days of their lives. For this, let us pray to the Lord.
For our departed brothers and sisters, and all who have died in the hope of the resurrection, especially the late Stephen Harry Sawyer, that they may continue to rest peacefully in the bosom of our Lord. For this, let us pray to the Lord.
As we pray, Lord, as we pray, hear our prayer. In the silence of our hearts, let us put before God our individual intentions. We pray in a special way for marriages going through tough times, that God will visit them. We commit Manuel and Natasha. We commit this marriage in a special way. God, our Father, we thank you for the union between Manuel and Natasha. be with this marriage in a special way. Be their buckler and their shield. Be a pillar of cloud by day and a pillar of fire by night over them. May they never lack any blessing. And may the best years in their lives be seen in the years after today. We pray that whatever is good, whatever is pleasant, whatever they desire, if it be for the good of their souls, you, O God, will grant unto them. Hear our individual prayers, and may this day be a sign of your faithfulness to us. We make all our prayers through Christ our Lord. Amen. Shall we please be seated?
Brothers and sisters in Christ, it is now time for collection. We invite the ushers forward to the collection basket and harmonious choral lead us in a medley of songs. Thank you.
Thank you.
We shall continue with Catholic hymn number 350, hymn 350, Guide Me, O Thou Great Redeemer. Let us please stand.
And yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
Accept the sacrifice at Mass for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Receive, we pray, O Lord, the offering made on the occasion of the sealing of the sacred bond of marriage between Manuel and Natasha, and just as your goodness is its origin, may your providence guide its course. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you have forged the covenant of marriage as a sweet yoke of harmony and a breakable bond of peace, so that the chaste and fruitful love of holy matrimony may serve to increase the children you adopt as your own. By your providence and grace, O Lord, you accomplished the wonder of this twofold design, why the birth of children brings beauty to the world, their rebirth in baptism gives increase to the Church through Christ our Lord. Through him, with the angels and all the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim.
Let us please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it, and gave it to disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith, we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, John Bonaventure, our Bishop, and his auxiliaries, John and Anthony, and all the clergy.
Be mindful also, Lord, of Niamu and Sednam, we have brought to their wedding day, so that by your grace they may abide in mutual love and in peace. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. And with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Let us stand.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, let us turn to the Lord and pray that he will bless with his grace this woman, Natasha Rosalind, now married in Christ to this man, Manuel, and that through the sacrament of the body and blood of Christ, he will unite in love the couple he has joined in this holy bond. Father, by your power, you have made everything out of nothing. In the beginning, you created a universe and made mankind in your own likeness. You gave man the constant help of woman, so that man and woman should no longer be two, but one flesh. And you teach us that what you have united may never be divided. Father, you have made the union of man and wife so holy a mystery that it symbolizes the marriage of Christ and his church. Father, by your plan, man and woman are united, and married life has been established as the one blessing that was never forfeited by original sin or washed away in the flood. Look with love upon this woman, your daughter, now joined in holy matrimony to her husband. She asks your blessing. Give her the grace of love and peace. May she always follow the example of the holy woman whose praises are sung in the scriptures. May her husband put his trust in her and recognize that she is his equal and the heir with him to the life of grace. May he always honor her and love her as Christ loves his bride, the church. Father, keep them always true to your commandments. Keep them faithful in marriage and let them be living examples of Christian life. Give them the strength which comes from the gospel, so that they may be witnesses of Christ to others. Bless them with children and help them to be good parents. May they live to see their children's children, and after a happy old age, grant them fullness of life with the saints in the kingdom of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
With a wave, let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Oh,
Please let us kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Shall we please be seated? Beloved in Christ, it is now time for Holy Communion. Let us remember that Holy Communion is reserved for only practicing Catholics. However, those who are not Catholics but would want to come for blessing are invited to join the line. Only you have to cross your arms to indicate that you want blessing. So you cross your arms like this to join the queue so that you can be blessed. Apart from that, only Catholics are taking Holy Communion. For Holy Communion, we shall sing from Catholic hymn number 348, hymn 348, Love Divine, All Loves Excelling.
Shall we stand and pray? By the power of this sacrifice, O Lord, accompanied with your loving favor, what in your providence you have instituted, so as to make of one heart in love, Manuel and Natasha, whom we have joined in this holy union, and replenished with the one bread and the one chalice, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated. Before the signing of the marriage register, may I have the singular honor to acknowledge in our midst the Vice President of the Republic, His Excellency Dr. Mahmoud Bawumia. Also in our midst, the First Lady, Her Excellency Mrs. Rebecca Akufo-Addo. We also have the Chief of Staff, Honorable Akosua Frema-Osei Opare. And the Attorney General and Minister of Justice, Honorable Godfred Yabu Adame. I can see many more of you, distinguished personalities, and I know at the reception you'll all be acknowledged. Thank you very much. So I now invite Manuel and Natasha and two members from their respective families to please come and sign the marriage register.
Harmonious Choral will lead us in a medley of songs, so I will do the signing. Thank you.
Oh,
On this truly magnificent and beautiful day, in front of an even more magnificent and beautiful congregation, I stand here with the absolute honor and pleasure of introducing to you the latest, most beautiful, most edified, most sanctified, and blessed couple in town, Mr. and Mrs. Manuel Harry Sawyer. Thank you.
for the blessing. May God, the all-powerful Father, grant you his joy and bless you and your children. Amen. May the only begotten Son of God stand by you with compassion in good times and in bad. Amen. May the Holy Spirit of God always pour forth his love into your hearts. Amen. And may the Almighty God bless all of you who are gathered here, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in the peace of the Lord. The Mass is ended.